Hey, happy Thursday, everybody. Mark again here at Weatherman Plus. I'm going to give you the latest update on what's going on in the tropics. So we're seeing with the GFS as well as the Ural a western shift. Matter of fact, the Ural control member is seeing a system. It's seeing maybe a weak tropical storm, but it's seeing the same thing, a system curving around Cuba and going by Florida. Now, we're seeing the same thing by GFS, but I believe it is going to do that stall effect because of the high pressure that's coming. And the high pressure is blocking its path going out through the east in the Caribbean. So that's been trending as well. So I think we're going to see the stall potentially by Jamaica. And then it's going to go to the west. Now I'm going to show you the latest information so you know what to expect. I'm going to show you everything in the atmosphere so you can see why I'm coming to my conclusion. I see a lot of people saying, don't worry about this. Please keep your heads up about this because GFS has been very accurate all year. Matter of fact, we even seen the Ural come dramatically to the GFS on some of these ensembles and some of these hurricanes. We didn't even see the Ural for Hurricane Milton. So please pay attention to this. Don't let people tell you to blow this off. Do not blow this off. Matter of fact, our favorable environment has grown all the way from late October going into early November. Even more favorable environment coming in for the beginning of November, mostly for the Caribbean and eastward. Now, here's a few things I want to show you. All you need is 80 degrees Fahrenheit to sustain a tropical system. Now, 80 degrees Fahrenheit would be all the way down to this 27 degrees Celsius. So this very thin line of very bright yellow. This would be below 80. Right here, right close to shore is cooled off, but everything else, all the way from this orange going all the way around the Gulf and stronger, is at least 80. All this red to the brown goes from 84 and above, and you can see what is in the Caribbean where this is forming. This is very strong temperatures to help something form, and we have very low wind shear right now. And just like I do every day, you can see the update with the deep ocean heat content. So as it sits there and gets blocked with this front and does this stall, look at all this deep ocean heat that it has to tap into, plus all the warm sea surface temperatures that will help this storm form. GFS sees this going from a tropical storm towards a hurricane forming by Jamaica. We're going to see a wiggle. When this high pressure comes in, when this high pressure comes wiggling in, it's going to do a form of a block like this. This would cause the storm to go up here by Jamaica, maybe do this stall that's been trending like crazy. But then the high pressure is going to move over here with the trough, and it's going to make this turn. So it's going to go towards Jamaica, then it's going to turn because of what the high pressure is doing. And this is bringing it into our Gulf of Mexico once again. Plus, you can see that we have all this lift, all this rise in motion that's going to be passing through as we go from the 26th of October through the 31st of October. This would help thunderstorms grow. That's why you see so many surface low pressures on the model runs, because these thunderstorms are literally popping and trying to form like crazy. Now, as we go past October 31st, this is where everything starts. Everything's showing it's going to be an area of low pressure until then, and it has a chance to form because we do have a lot of lift in the environment. But once we go past the 31st, and we go all the way from the 31st through the 5th, it's been trending this for a while now. This intensifies. Matter of fact, if you look at the latest information, you will see that the favorable environment, instead of going around like it did a minute ago, it is raising up into the Gulf of Mexico for stronger lift to form. This would help this storm system. So as it moves to the west, it would keep itself very strong. As you check the chances for a tropical depression, you can see here with the Ural that it starts building up. Then it starts heading north as it goes into the beginning of November. This is where the system forms and it starts headed towards Jamaica. And right there in that red, that's 100% chance of at least a tropical depression, by the way. Showing as we go 5 and 6 days away, this tropical wave is going to start building up. And then as we go 7, 8 days away, there we get that block from the Pacific and everything starts headed back towards the east. This is where we're still in late October, going to the very beginning of November. Now, if you watch it, you'll see that it goes towards Jamaica as you're going towards 10 days. Then it stops right there, and this is where it does its stall. And after that, it starts moving further, either north or to the west or to the east. You can see the different outcomes of where this system can go. But once again, this is all the way by November 5th, and that's very important. Now, this is why it is important, and I'm going to show you with the euro, I'm going to show you all the models with the trends and everything, so you see what I'm talking about. So as we keep going, as you're a 500 millibar vorticity, you see we start getting this trough building in. See that trough coming all the way into the Caribbean. Now, this right here, this big trough, would stop anything from forming right now, and it would keep everything suppressed down here. That's the trend. All the way to the 30th and 31st is when things start to get let go and starts growing. So you can see how that gets suppressed by the euro. Then afterwards, it moves away. So afterwards, we get some convection. Remember, this front does create convection. So afterwards, we get convection. We get rotation going on. And you can see the size of the whole area. Now, there's surface lows all over the place on the euro, just like the GFS, showing there's a lot of robust thunderstorms going on because we have all this lift passing over. At the same time, we're only November 2nd. And if you watch, you'll see that this high pressure right here, this upper level high, moves over towards the east. So when that happens, this system has nowhere to go but this direction because it's getting blocked right there. So let me show you what the GFS sees as well. So as we go towards the end of October, here's an upper level high starting to do a block. Now GFS takes it to where it has a little more room to breathe in these thunderstorms, and it starts forming up already by Jamaica by the time we go to the end of October. This is going from a tropical storm, trying to become a hurricane. But once again, you can see this upper level high over here, and this is moving further towards the east. You see that? It's moving towards the east, and that creates that blocking pattern to where it can't go out through the east. And then it starts strengthening up in that deep ocean heat. This has been run after run, and we're seeing that westward push going all the way into the Gulf, potentially getting grabbed by that trough and pulling it right on in. We've seen this over and over and over. So as we look with the ensembles, we can see with the GFS showing as you go towards the end of October, more likely we'll get something forming up. It is confident that we will get this tropical storm trying to become a hurricane over by Jamaica. Then once you go literally about 7 days, it starts getting a little all over the place because we have all this lift going on and everything is just bubbling, just like I showed you yesterday. Now on this one, it shows it could either go out to the west a little weaker up here, or it could stay with this strong one that got stalled over that front, sit over the deep ocean heat, and go into the west. It could go further to the west, but it could head to the northwest, showing potentially major hurricane could be forming up somewheres in that western Caribbean. Now, some of the model runs is taking it further where it's going towards Florida. We don't quite know just yet if it's going that far. So far, we're seeing a stall. Then we're seeing a westward push. This could zigzag some more. So let's take a look at some of the trends that we're seeing. So as we're seeing, starting with yesterday, after my upload yesterday, the 12Z came out. You see that high pressure blocking it over here. And literally, as we go by the end of October, the beginning of November, it still shows that we have this storm building up, still showing potentially multiple storms, multiple vortices. It's not an ensemble run, this is a model run. Showing that still bringing that big threat towards Jamaica, then showing that it's going to go further towards the west and get into our Gulf, and still maybe getting that second one going by the Caribbean, maybe by the Bahamas later on. Still showing we could have two, but look at this. That's the worst case scenario. That's going the exact same path as Helene. So let's try and see what the GFS has been seeing after that. The 18Z, this came right after the 12, showing the exact same information. It's either east or west of Jamaica. But look at this, just sits there and stalls even longer time, then finally does head somewhat to that west. But by then, we're already running out. It's been sitting there for so long, stalling and growing, it didn't even get there yet. And that's showing that it's going down to a major hurricane. So let's look at the 0Z. This is what was right after that last night. Showing the same thing. It's either west or east of Jamaica, showing a very long stall on Jamaica, and showing a major hurricane going to the west. Showing it's going into the Gulf. Now it's going to another portion of Florida. Now, this would be a fourth landfall this year. We had it three landfalls in 2004, 2005, and we had three in this year. This could be a potential fourth. So as we look at the 6Z, this just come out this morning right after the 0Z, showing the exact same thing again, that we have a tropical storm, potential hurricane, forming by Jamaica, potentially doing a nice stall, then going to the west. We're seeing it over and over and over. So let's look at the Euro ensembles. You can see with the Euro showing us a possibility that it could form up and do just like what the GFS is seeing. And that could sit there and stall and strengthen, then go to the west or shoot out through the north. You see this? Then go back. It all depends about timing. So Euro is seeing that strengthening, is seeing that westward push. As far as going all the way into the Gulf, that's a little bit questionable. I'm thinking maybe a path like this would be possible. That would be a little unbelievable at this point. But after this year's been going, I wouldn't put it past what could possibly happen. So look at the latest on the Euro. This is the control member. It goes past the 10 days because you can see the 10 days shows something building up right here by Jamaica. As you go past 10 days, it's not showing as strong as GFS, but it's seeing that westward push. It's seeing a big, broad system. Look at the size of this system. This is a big, huge, broad area of tropical moisture with bubbling low pressures all over the place and going out into that direction. And you can see this with the Euro showing almost the same path. See, I don't see it going all the way into the Gulf, but it is still possible. We got to watch this, everyone. Just because the Euro shows this in 10 days does not mean that this is not going to be forming up afterwards, because the Euro sees that as well. Please heed my advice. We have something potentially stalling in the Caribbean, then headed potentially to the west. That is trending. So let's go to the ensembles. As we look at 7 days, this is right at the 31st, and you can see that a lot of these are showing formation, forming up, some weak, some stronger. And this right here is your control member. So let's go by the control member first is your more than likely outcome. And as you go past 7 days, you can see it more likely will form up by Jamaica, get a little bit of that stall going on for a couple of days, and then headed to the west, going right over Florida and maybe up the coast as well. Now, when we look at the rest of these ensembles, you can see in some of these ensembles, literally this is already right here. This is your 10 days where it shows it's still going by Jamaica. Look at the rest of these showing almost the same thing, that over by the Jamaica region, that we have something that could be forming up and could be a big problem. This one is really big and broad, but look at this. It is trending that something is forming up right by the Caribbean, right by Jamaica, that we need to keep our heads on, because later on it's showing that it could do that westward push. It could be westward, or look at this right here, it could go to that eastward. It all depends, from what I can see, if it's going to be on the east side of Jamaica or if it's going to be more like the west side of Jamaica. Depends on which way that this thing is going to turn. Thank you for your time, everybody. Hope you have a great day today. Now, starting Sunday, I am going to start afternoon updates on what's going on with this tropical wave that we're going to be going into next week. So make sure you click that bell and select all. That way you get all the updates. Now, before we go, I know a lot of people are tempted to celebrate what's at the end of this month. And if you're a true believer, you really should not celebrate this holiday. You can't celebrate both and be happy for Jesus Christ and God and celebrate the day of evil. You just can't, everybody. Please keep yourself in check. You got to control yourself. You know how we are. Don't ride your emotions. Your emotions can deceive you. Just be aware of that. Stay strong and stay fast to the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 5:14 through 23. Now we exhort you, brethren, warn them that are unruly, comfort the feeble-minded, support the weak, be patient toward all men. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. Rejoice evermore, pray without ceasing, and everything give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Quench not the spirit, despise not prophesying, Prove all things. Hold fast that which is good. Abstain from all appearance of evil. And the very God of peace sanctify you wholly. And I pray, God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I will see you first thing for tomorrow morning. This is getting pretty concerning from what I'm seeing here. And if this keeps trending, I think we have a very big problem on our hands. Thank you all for help sharing the word to other people. I appreciate it so much. Y'all are literally saving lives. And remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you in the morning.